Today, our topic of discussion is transcription in eukaryotes with reference to the prokaryote system. Here, we are going to focus on the eukaryotic system, but primarily with respect to the prokaryotic system. We are just going to see the differences with the prokaryotic system. So, what is transcription? Transcription is the process by which the DNA molecule is transcribed, or DNA molecule is getting transformed into RNA molecule, be it mRNA, rRNA or tRNA, with the help of enzyme RNA polymerase. So in the case of prokaryotes, we have already discussed that the RNA pol is basically of one type. But here we are going to see that RNA pol in the case of eukaryotes is of 1, 2 and 3. First type of RNA pol is responsible for catalyzing the formation of mRNA and rRNA, particularly the 18S, 5.8S rRNA. The second subunit is responsible for the catalyzing the synthesis of mRNA, and the third is responsible for the synthesis of tRNA and also the 5S rRNA. So it is responsible for the formation. So RNA polymerase 1 here is responsible for the synthesis of 18S, 5.8S. RNA polymerase 2 in the case of eukaryotes responsible for the formation of the mRNA, and RNA polymerase 3 is responsible for the formation of tRNA and also 5S rRNA. Now, one more thing to be kept in mind is that the process of transcription in the case of eukaryotes takes place inside the nucleus, unlike that of the prokaryotes, where it takes place in the cytoplasm. So the transcription process in the case of eukaryotes takes place in the inside the nucleus. Now let's come to the same thing which we have done here. Also, we are going to have a start point from where the transcription process starts. Then we have, in spite of the Pribnow box or the -10 sequence which was present in the case of prokaryotes, here in the we are having a -25 sequence, which is known as the Hockness box, It is basically a Tata box. And we also have a -75 sequence, where we are going to have a CAAT box. And also we are having a -90 sequence in some cases, which is the GC rich box at the same time. So we are having a GC rich sequence and -90 sequence, which we are not showing in this moment. So here we are going to have this two, the Hockness box, -25 sequence, and also the -35 sequence. These sequences are required for the proper binding of the RNA polymerase. So this is what we are having. These are the differences which we see. And here also we are having this, the strand, which is also in the 3' to 5' direction. This is known as the template strand, and the other strand, which is going to be similar to that of the mRNA, which is going to be synthesized, is what is known as the coding strand. Now let's come to the process of transcription. Again, the process of transcription can be divided into initiation, elongation, and also termination. In the initiation process, first there will be the formation of the promoter sequence. First, there will be the binding of the RNA polymerase to the promoter sequence. This binding of the promoter sequence will next lead to the formation of the complex, which is the pre-initiation complex. It will lead to the formation. So first we are going to do is what is a form is a promoter binding, then is the formation of the pre-initiation complex. This pre-initiation complex formation requires many transcription factors. The transcription factors which are required are basically, first, to the RNA molecule there will be binding of something called the Tata binding protein, TBP. This will lead to formation, this will lead to the attachment of transcription factor 2D. This will lead to the formation of transcription factor 2A. Then this will lead to the formation of transcription, for not formation, attachment of FA, BA, and then B. Then it will lead to the activation of F, then transcription factor 2E, and then transcription factor 2H. Now, this is the protein which will bind initially. This is the TBP. TBP molecule is a binding is very, very important, which is required for the entire transcription process to continue. Then this transcription factor 2H will having two functions. One, it helps in the excision repair, and also it also plays a role or also helps to maintain the stability of the RNA pole on the template strand. So it also helps to maintain the stability of the RNA pole on the template strand, and also helps in the process of excision repair. So this will lead to the formation, or this will lead to the what is known as the pre-initiation complex formation. After the pre-initiation complex has been formed, there is going to be the bending. There will be a bending of the DNA molecule. It will, after the first Tata binding protein forms, and the second protein, the transcription factor 2D, which is the largest transcription factor, this is the largest transcription factor which binds, it will lead to the bending of the DNA strand. There will be bending of the DNA strand, and this bending of the DNA strand is basically required for the other transcription factors to bind. Now, after this has after this process of the pre-initiation complex has been formed, the cell enters the stage of cell starts to incorporate the various ribonucleotides, and then it starts the process of elongation. It soon enters the process of what is known as the next step, is the elongation. In the case of eukaryotes, can be divided into the same, the phosphodiester bond, or the formation of the phosphodiester bonds. Here also there will be formation of the phosphodiester bonds as it will move forward. So elongation in this step is basically elongation having a phosphodiester bond, and it also plays a role in the proofreading process. It also has a role in the proofreading process to check whether the incorporated ribonucleotides are correctly incorporated or not. If there is some mistake, it is soon then going to have an endonuclease activity and cleave that sequence and again start the process of transcription. So it is just a check in the process of transcription. So this proofreading mechanism is an additional point which is present only in the eukaryotic process. And finally, we are going to have the termination process, where we are having a particular sequence called such as AAUAA. We are having a sequence like AAUAA. This is a sequence which is known as the cleavage polyadenylate factor. This sequence AAUAA, which is known as the cleavage polyadenylation factor, is a requirement for the termination in the case of the eukaryotes. So this is a sequence which is required for the termination process. And finally, we are going to have release factors like ERF1 and ERF3 for the release or for the breakage or the cleavage factors for the cleavage of the RNA and the DNA hybrid, or the breakdown of the RNA and the DNA hybrid, as we have seen mostly in the case of the prokaryotic system. One more important difference is that here, after the transcription process, as we have discussed that in prokaryotes we do not have any post-transcriptional modification, here in the case of eukaryotes we have got something called the prokaryotic, we are having something called the post-transcriptional modification. We have got post-transcriptional modification. These post-transcriptional modifications are very important. There are various kinds of post-transcriptional modifications. We are going to just discuss some. We are going to have a poly-A-tailing, which will prevent. We are having a poly-A-tailing, or after the transcript of the mRNA has been synthesized, it is having a chain which is having AAAA sequence. This is because of poly-A tailing will prevent from the telomerase activity or the endonuclease activity which is present, and prevents the mRNA from further nuclease damage. Next, we are having a capping, 5' capping. This is done by seven methyl guanosine phosphate. This 7-methyl guanosine phosphate is a protein, or it's a basically a molecule which is added to the mRNA molecule after it has been transcribed, so that it makes it easier for the ribosomes to detect the correct location or the correct initiation point of the translation. Moreover, we can also undergo process of methylation. Methylation is also a very important post-transcriptional modification which takes place. So in most cases, it is required to in various biological processes where methylation is very, very important for the catalytic activity in the future cases. And finally, so these three are basically the most important, and we can also have some more, but these three primarily are the most important post-transcriptional modifications which we have in eukaryotic system. Now, coming to the clinical aspects. The clinical aspects of the eukaryotic transcription is that there are several drugs which will inhibit the process of transcription. This is mostly given in the case of cancer. So the mostly used inhibitors of transcription are in the anti-cancer drugs, which will inhibit the formation of various carcinogenic proteins, and thus it will prevent the metastasis and the growth of cancer. So this is what we have for the eukaryotic transcription, and please refer to the prokaryotic transcription video for further details, because there we have discussed the transcription process in much more details. Here we are just giving an overview of the entire thing with reference to the prokaryotic system. That is very, very important, and that has to be kept in mind. So thank you.